Pleasure, sir.
You
I wish I'll
have
do my job with all your cooperation, sir.
our cooperation. You have a very great job to do. We wish you will hold this post for as long as Dr. Chandrasekhar held it and continue to amass more wealth than he did for us. Thank you.
Yeah, now we move on to next topic, very important topic, not but the least. Whenever we have a dilemma in our life, a difficulty in life, we have to call the elders or learned persons or very intellectual persons, I mean, to clear out the dilemma and diagnostic dilemma. So now we have a great dilemma in the tuberculosis pain. It still persists and still exists in our life. So now I call upon Dr. Muthamparubal to talk about a diagnostic dilemma in tuberculosis spine. I welcome Dr. Muthamparubal, sir. Over to you, sir.
Good evening, all of you. I am audible now, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, yes, sir.
Thank you for selecting me for this talk. Thanking the selection committee for selecting me for the topic here. And sorry, I don't have any slide presentation.
Great, sir.
You go ahead, sir. No problem.
We are very happy.
The case I diagnosed, this happened about 15 years ago. So I don't have the exact details, but I remember the details in vivid. A girl aged 16 years was brought to me to my house in the early morning by her parents and close relatives. Actually, they wanted a second opinion where to take the girl. Because the girl was being treated by another practitioner for more than two months. She had severe pain in both legs from hip to toe. And she was prescribed various analgesics, antibiotics, etc. And day by day, the condition was getting bad. And finally, the neuroband injection also was started on alternate days basis. That was also not effective. When I saw the patient, as Dr. Sudhir said, the clear history was observed. I was eliciting the history. That is the only analgesia and paresthesia in the both limbs and pain. That was the only presenting symptom, no other. She had, but on inquiry, she revealed that she had some loss of appetite recently and loss of weight also. And there was no history of fever. But I presume because of the analgesic continuous use, the fever was not exhibited. So the parents and the relatives are very in urgent mood. They want immediate action, because they have waited more than 2 months and the girl is suffering. Then I examined. I saw the back. I elicited the tenderness over T12 and L1 level. And she did not complain the pain, back pain also herself, but I only elicited the tenderness. So I thought it needs urgent attention. So gave a reference letter to Dr. Selvam for further action. She was diagnosed with TB spine and was operated. And she continued ATP for more than a year. And she became completely all right with no residual symptoms. That's a short story about this patient. That's all my presentation, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. Muthamparubal, sir.
Thanks.
Short and sweet. Elders never speaks too wide. They'll speak only short and sweet. In that, they will say, deliver whatever they want, the very preciously. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, nice, sir.
President, anything you want to convey?
The only thing we are missing in this meeting is the person who grabs the mic, comes to the podium, and says, this is the treatment. This is what I do. What you are doing is wrong.
Definitely, sir. We are missing him, sir.
After every lecture, it will be there. What you are saying is wrong. What this is doing is correct.
Definitely, exactly. We are missing
that,
him, sir.
That too, he comes from back.
Last row.
That is very important.
Last row. Last he row. Will grab the mic. He will come to the podium. He will push the speaker, saying, no, this is right.
And a very important announcement I wanted to say to our members, because the elders who are crossed over 60, I advise not to practice now. Because we should not venture to have a herd immunity at the present situation. This pattern of the virus, this pattern of the unknown enemy will not be understood perfectly, completely, even in the developed countries. The developed countries like USA and United Kingdom, even Japan and Korea, they are all experiencing the second wave. Even because in the recent times in the USA, when you go through the literature and the newspapers, because even the recently the area like Houston and also the, from the state called, because younger peoples are being affected. Like 25 to 35 years, more are, I mean, being affected and being admitted in hospitals. So that because the scenario previously was different, now this is different. So I humbly request to the elders and seniors over the crossed over 60, not to do practice. You have to wait for at least for 2 months, then you can do the practice. Then I wanted to quote important saying by Jack Ma, like he is a billionaire and industrialist and businessman from Chinese. When you throw a banana and money to the monkey will grab the banana. He will not catch the money, because he doesn't know that money can buy more bananas. But in vice versa, if you throw the money and banana to the human being, suddenly my thought is blocked.
Sir, paravala sir, engala korangunu sollada varike sari sir.
Illa, idu romba important. Jack Ma said.
Sir, okay, we'll wait.
I will tell you.
We'll wait, sir, no problem.
Yeah, we'll wait. இப்ப குரங்க கிட்ட வந்து நம்ம வந்து ஒரு பழத்தை போடுறோம், அதே சமயத்துல பணத்தை போடுறோம், பழம் அண்ட் பணம். குரங்க என்ன பண்ணும் அப்படின்னா, பழத்தை எடுத்து சாப்பிட்டுக்கும், மணி எடுக்கவே எடுக்காது. ஏன் எடுக்காது அப்படின்னா, இப்ப சப்போஸ் வந்து அந்த அதுக்கு தெரியாது இந்த மணியை வச்சு நிறைய பழத்தை வாங்கலான்னு. பட் அதே சமயத்துல மனிதன்கிட்ட வந்து நம்ம என்ன பண்றோம்னா, ஒரு பணத்தையும் போடுறோம் பழத்தையும் போறோம் அப்படின்னா, முதல்ல பணத்தை எடுத்து எடுத்துக்குவான். ஆனா அவனுக்கு தெரியாது, முதல்ல வந்து நம்ம ரெஸ்ட் எடுத்துட்டா தான் அந்த ரெஸ்டின் மூலம் நிறைய பணத்தை நம்ம சம்பாதிக்க முடியும் என்கிற ஒரு அறிவை வந்து அவர் எடுத்துக்க முடியாது. தட் இஸ் வாட் ஐ வாண்டட் டு கன்வே டு யூ. சோ ஜாக் மா, இட்ஸ் a very good saying, பட் ஐ ரெட் இட் somewhere, so that I wanted to convey to you, it is also useful to you. That is why with this I wanted to give some advice and some request to you.
Sir, now ஒரு 2 minutes. The demise of Dr. Chandrasekaran has brought to light a couple of points. I leave you all to ponder over these points. Number one, he was always talking about herd immunity. Unfortunately, this herd immunity never came. I think that this virus, which mutates so rapidly and so many times to form multiple viruses, I don't think we will develop a herd immunity. This is number one point which we have to think about. So unnecessary exposure to the virus, kindly avoid. Number two point, try to wear a mask at all times. A kerchief mask or a sari mask or a dupatta mask is not enough. A minimum of a melt-blown 3-ply mask like what we supplied, or a N95 mask, can be worn at all times to protect yourself if you must practice. If you can avoid practice and assume that you are going away to visit your children or grandchildren in America or Australia or Canada for 6 months, let us say, and then you assume that this COVID period is such a holiday, it will be the best relaxation for you. You can write a book. Many of you can write memoirs, autographies. Many of you can spend time with family. Some hobby that you may have, which you always wanted to do, which you cannot do. These things you can do. Focus a little more on something else. There are many online courses. The ladies can learn a lot of things. Just for example, my wife was always busy as a yoga teacher. Now, 4 months she is at home, she has become a wonderful cook. Not because I'm a prisoner eating everything, but because she has really improved. So something like that. Some people may improve on something else. You may learn some computer skills, some mobile skills. Maybe the grandchildren can teach you something and think.